After slipping her mooring lines from the cleats on the dock and watching the Mango motor out of the marina, a weird wave of emotion swept over me. A little loneliness with almost a bit of guilt. I was feeling like I had just let the crew down, leaving them before this last long stretch of adventure crossing the Philippine Sea. Not being on board to augment late night lookout watches and not manning the helm, I knew exactly what I needed to do. I'd been on land way too long and my sea legs had left me.
So I need to pack my sea bags and catch up with the sailing vessel Mango. Flying almost 2,000 miles, staying in a hotel down here in southern Philippines, I walk to the end of the dock and I look out and I see the sailing vessel Mango en route right to the customs building. I missed him. I didn't miss him. I actually beat him by about probably 5 minutes. So perfect timing. So I'm heading down, gonna try to meet Kevin and Jonah Lynn, and I should see them in about 10 minutes. Go grab my stuff at the hotel where I just staged my bags and catch up to the sailing vessel Mango. Okay, after a long extensive walk down through back alleys, and I found their dinghy. So there's the Mango's dinghy. Now I just gotta track down Kevin and Jonna Lynn. approach the San Juanico Bridge here. O'clock in the morning, we weighed anchor at 7:30. We're nearly just out of the... Yeah, that's what that is. Oh, is it? We're nearly out of the San Juanico Pass, so it's taken us just over 2 hours. And see Villaran Island over here. It's quite the successful passage there, only one scare. And that was the bridge, and we have plenty of room. Actually, the aerials, the power lines were even higher than the bridge, so plenty of room with a nearly 50-foot mast. So.
Enjoyed it, and soon to be in Malapascua. All right.